It's only been a week into the new year, and I already want to give up so bad. Hey guys, my name is Sheba, and you're watching my first YouTube video. I hope to be posting videos about things that I'm super passionate about, like the Word of God. I love to travel and have new experiences. So I hope that you follow me on this new journey by subscribing. It's a new year, and there's just something so exciting about coming into a new year, even though nothing's really changed from the past year. I just love the fact that we have a reset button and also that we can start off on a clean slate. And this year I've written out two resolutions for myself. One of them is to take the risk. I oftentimes tend to overthink and spend months waiting and thinking and being paralyzed by fear to pursue that dream that God has placed in my heart. So this year I'm like, go ahead and do the thing. Stop waiting around. Stop overthinking. And guess what? You are witnessing the development of my New Year's resolution to take the risk. Start a YouTube channel is one of them. And it has not been easy. It's only been a week into the new year, and I already want to give up so bad because I have spent hours, I mean hours, writing, brainstorming, trying to think about what would be a great first video. And then I start filming the video. I watch it and I'm like, no, I don't want to share this with the world. It's not good. And I have all these doubts of, well, YouTube is already saturated with stuff, content like what you're doing. Why even try? And honestly, I have created 3 videos on 3 different topics, and I've watched them and I have not liked them. So they're in the garbage right now. But perhaps all of this was not wasted because here I am sharing with you about my process. And I just want to encourage y'all as well. I read this really awesome quote that motivated me the other day, and I want to share it with you. It says, "A comfort zone is a beautiful place, but nothing ever grows there." And that was just so deep to me. That really resounded with me. And it got me thinking about the story in the Old Testament about the Israelites. That every time God had called them out to step out in faith, they always wanted to go back. When they were in the wilderness, they wanted to go back to Egypt, where they were actually slaves. And then when God called them into the promised land, they wanted to stay in the wilderness. And it got me thinking, maybe the comfort zone isn't actually a comfortable place. Maybe it's just an environment that we've gotten used to for so long because we know what to expect. It's not actually the best place for us, but at least there are no unpredictable surprises. At least we don't have to fear the unknown. And this is where we get settled. We become content and stuck in this place instead of moving into the better plans that God has for us. We see this with the Israelites. They were paralyzed by fear to go into the promised land because they were scared of the unknown. There's a story in the book of Numbers chapter 13 where Moses sends out 12 spies into the promised land, and they all bring back a report. They all agree that this land is awesome. It is flowing with milk and honey, and that means it's a really good place to be prosperous and to thrive in. Eventually, 10 of the spies start spreading a negative report. They talk about the people who live in this land are like giants. They're strong and powerful, and in their presence, they look like grasshoppers. They would never be able to defeat these people. But there were 2 spies who had a faith-filled perspective, and they remember that God is all-powerful, and when God promises something, it will come to pass. But the negative report of the 10 spies spread throughout the camp, and the Israelites were filled with fear. So they revolted against Moses, Caleb, and Joshua, and they did not want to go into the promised land. Because of their unbelief, they had to wander in the wilderness for another 40 years. Can you imagine that? That wasn't God's intended plan for them. And it reminds me that it's never actually the giants that keep us out of the promised land. It's never actually the physical obstacles that prevent us from living those dreams that God has placed in our hearts or from taking that risk. A lot of times it's our own unbelief, it's our own lack of faith that prevent us from walking into those plans that God had for us. The 10 scouts were scared of the potential danger, even though God had given them this incredible promise that he will deliver their enemies into their hands. Do you ever feel like these 12 spies live inside of your head? I mean, 10 of them, which is the majority, are like, don't do it. What if the worst possible thing happens? I mean, what if you fail? And 2 of them are like, chill, girl, try it. Give it your best shot. It's better to try than fail. So I just want to encourage you, as we're going into this new year, don't let fear outnumber faith. Don't let fear paralyze you from taking that risk, living out that God dream. Maybe you've been waiting for the right time and you've been stalling time, but I just want to tell you, the time is here. Step out by faith. And yes, it will feel a little uncomfortable, but discomfort is something that we can embrace because it means that there's movement in our lives. It means that we are growing. We're not stuck. I would love to hear what some of those things are, those dreams, those goals that you have for this year, or maybe you've been stalling out on them. Write them down in the comments below and I would love to read them. Thanks for joining. Have a great day.